on John and Lucy's Odd Couples.
I can stay here forever!
Two celebrity pairs put their relationship on the line in a series of challenges.
How about we do the whole thing in silence?
All in an attempt to show that they are the perfect couple.
You think you're funnier than me?
I am funnier than you.
And welcome to John and Lucy's Odd Couples. I'm John Richardson.
And I'm Lucy Beaumont, John's much, much, much better half.
This is the show where Lucy and I see how our relationship stacks up against two other celebrity couples before we drive home together in total silence and never talk about it again.
Our winners tonight will go home with the title of Best Couple. Our losers will just go home.
Let's meet tonight's semi-willing celebrity guinea pigs. Countdown's Rachel Riley and Strictly's Pasha Kovalev and comedians Richard Herring and Catie Wilkins. So, Rachel and Pasha, you obviously met on Strictly. Was it the sort of lycra and the sequins? Did that help get things going in the early stages?
I think if you're a good dancer, then it might be sexy, but if you're a rubbish dancer and it's the most cringy thing you could possibly do, then you just feel like this the whole time. It's like the least sexy thing. And he's just, like, superhuman. He can do everything except play squash.
Squash?
Can't play squash.
Catie, when you met Richard, was it the lycra and the sequins?
Yes, it was.
Yeah. Who made the first move out of you two?
I think it was... I was sort of very interested in Catie. She was with somebody else at the time. Invited me down to give a lecture at the university he worked at, but I only went because I fancied Catie.
God, you never hear a romance story where someone is stolen during a lecture.
And there was a rumour on the circuit that you were quite well endowed as well.
Was there?
I knew that before I met you.
Did you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I actually wouldn't have had you on if I'd known. Now, let's face it, you'd have to be nuts to let Lucy and I actually judge our couples, so we've outsourced the proper work. Please meet our in-house relationship therapist, Charlene Douglas.
So that's how I know when it's my turn, when everything goes silent, then. Charlene, you like to focus on specific area of relationships, don't you? So what will you be doing tonight?
So tonight I'm looking at communication. Now, communication is so important in relationships. But what I'm also looking at is how we respond to negative feedback. Do we retaliate or do we welcome it with a smile?
Oh. What's the right answer?
A smile.
A smile, yeah.
He sulks. He's a sulker.
He sulks?
Yes, sulks. For days.
Is that correct, John? Is that what you do?
I don't want to talk about it. Now, at this point, you're obviously thinking, John, you charmer, you've built such a wonderful rapport with your guests in just a few minutes. So, I'm sorry to reveal that that's a lie. We've all met before. At our couple's retreat, we sold the trip to them as a relaxing spa break. But thanks to Charlene's expert guidance, we changed it to a gruelling range of activities designed to break their spirit and crush their will.
Like Butlins, have you been there?
Welcome to the retreat, an idyllic haven for couples to rediscover what made them fall in love in the first place, or to finally admit they've got nothing in common, cut the losses and divorce.
But I feel sorry for these trees.
What do you mean?
You know, when you see those poodles that have got, like, round heads and they're in bow ties and they've got f***ing leg warmers on.
Yeah?
I find it embarrassing. I think they wish they were dead. Oh, they're here. Oh! Hello, everyone.
Hi, gang.
Thanks for coming.
Thanks for having us.
You know what this is. We're going to play some games. We're going to sort of talk about the chinks in your relationships, basically as a ruse to cover up the rotting decay that is our marriage.
There might not be chinks in their relationship.
No, that's true. You might have perfect relationships, in which case this is going to be f***ing awful for us. Come upstairs, mind your step. It's very slippery.
This meeting is for Charlene to get to know our couples before they take part in challenges, to decide who is crowned the best couple at the end of the show. Is it true that 80% of communication is non-verbal?
Yeah, most people would say that, absolutely.
That's amazing. So when you're having a go at me for not talking to you over dinner, actually I am talking, just with my body.
OK, so should we get our couples in?
Hello there.
Hello.
Hi, guys.
Take a
Hello
seat.
There.
Hello.
So how would you describe communication in your relationship? Maybe Pasha and Rachel.
I think on a, like, on an emotional relationship level, it's quite good. On a day-to-day level, it's dreadful.
I think it's a language thing, yeah, because right from the beginning, I couldn't understand why would you say, would you like to do something? Not really, would you like me to do it for you? Yeah.
Is it bad, Charlene, that I'm actually thinking I'm going to behave a bit more like that? The eye contact is it's remarkable beautiful. While you talk. It's yeah, like watching a dance. You're lovely. You've got lovely eyes. Strong hands, I imagine, as well, if you held it from the dancing.
Do you think that's what you need to be caressed by a more alpha male?
I'm not into caressing. I'm not physical. I just want to be brutally sodomised. Oh.
So should we move on to the next couple?
We'll keep eye contact.
All right.
How would you describe the communication in your relationship?
I make jokes and you don't like them. That's the that's basically
oh, okay.
that's how we
that.
Communicate.
Sometimes. A joke doesn't help.
So I think what's really important here is to look at the difference between the body language. I'm looking at Pasha and Rachel and they're sitting really close to one another. And then I'm looking at John and Lucy. Maybe you're feeling a bit defensive and you're not feeling as close to each other right now.
No, on guard.
Under attack.
Yeah, it is to attack, but not in a violent way. In a kind way.
They love each other in a way that you'd usually say, yeah, well, it's fine for them, they haven't got kids. Except they've got two young kids. But that's obviously their specialist subject, you know, loving each other and looking at it. We'll crack them. I'll find a challenge where, like, they're not good at it. If we have to stay, I'll film here for a month until I win. How is it watching yourselves back in dressing gowns?
I thought I looked good. I thought I looked the best out of all the four of us.
Charlene, did you enjoy those therapy sessions or were you bored stiff?
It was so nice to see the interaction between the couples. And, of course, you know, it... you know, it was great to see the two of you.
Nice to see you too.
After their session with Charlene, we were going to give the couple some free time to enjoy the facilities, but sadly the hot stone massages and seaweed wraps were all booked up that afternoon.
Instead, I marched them down to the basement and hooked them up to a polygraph machine. Or if you grew up watching Jeremy Kyle, a lie detector. We had to go first, though, didn't we? So let's find out who the baby belongs to.
Yeah, got nothing to hide.
Have you ever told me I look good in something when I didn't?
Yes. I don't like jumpsuits.
Oh, here we go. I've got loads of jumpsuits.
I know, everyone has. They're a thing now.
What's your problem with them?
You look like big toddlers. You look like you should be handed a load of building blocks and left to play on the carpet.
Oh, unbelievable.
They even call them romper
That's
suits.
Something Piers Morgan would say.
Who goes on a romp? We've never romped. Why would you buy a romper suit?
Do you notice when I get my hair cut?
Yes. Because you're gone for 3 days. There's a big hole in my debit card. It takes you all fucking day.
Because my hairdresser's is in Leeds.
I have to do the school run and the pickup just for cutting your hair.
I'm in the chair for 4 hours.
Do you think I'll live beyond 70?
Yeah.
Do you want me to live beyond 70?
40.
Okay,
that's
you don't even need to answer the question. Does it really take all day to cut your hair?
Yeah.
Why are you gone all day when you have your hair cut?
Shopping.
Yeah, but why don't you just tell me? Because I like to be away from you. It makes me feel guilty.
Why don't you just say,
I mean, let's be honest. If I told you it was going to take all day to do my hair, you'd know I was lying. You don't even notice when I have my haircut.
Yeah, but you go to those places where outside they've got like pictures of Nike signs that they can shave in the back of the hair and stuff.
I only have my hair cut by men who call me boss man. I feel like it sort of got very hair-based and we sort of moved quite quickly on from you literally counting on your fingers when you want me to die.
30 years is all right, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not really a call for you to make. Well, after us, it was the couple's turn, so let's see if their nerves got the better of them.
The Honesty Room. Two couples, one genuine polygraph machine, and 1 point for the couple that lie the least.
Have you ever regretted dating or marrying me?
I only regret not meeting you sooner.
That's true! Do you think you're more talented than me? Oh! Answer the question.
Yes.
Yeah, that's true. Is there anything on your phone or laptop that you do not want me to see?
No.
That's a lie.
I don't know how the machine's that good.
Would you rather have a nice family dinner with me and the girls or go to the pub by yourself and have a Guinness?
Dinner with girls and you.
Pasha.
I'm thinking of Guinness now, you've got it up.
Do you wee in the shower?
I mean, not constantly.
Have you ever weed in our shower?
Yeah. Of course I have. When I met you, I was 40 years old and you were 27, which didn't seem so bad, did it? How do you feel about the fact that when you're 50, I'll be 63?
I had not done the maths on that.
Oh, OK. Are you looking forward to being my carer?
I'll be fine.
Well, that's a no there.
Do you think you're smarter than me?
Yeah. Only a little bit. You are very smart, but that's like my thing.
I count numbers in my head to music as well when I'm dancing, so pretty much doing the same job.
Okay, that's fine. Is there anything on your phone or laptop that you don't want me to see?
Yeah, but it's not porn.
Do you wee in the shower?
Yeah. Since I got pregnant, everything's gone out the window.
Am I more sexually attractive than you, Catie?
I think you're sexually attractive.
But do you think, you know, anyone looking at this knows the answer?
So before Charlene helps us to pick the bones out of the horror show we've just witnessed, it's time for a quick break. Maybe you could make a copper, or Pasha, we could pop for a Guinness.
Yeah, or you could just even text everyone you know and tell them Rachel Riley off Countdown wee's in the shower.
See you shortly.
To John and Lucy's Odd Couples, the show that looks at the 42% divorce rate and says, I think we can get that up a bit.
Earlier we saw both our couples getting down to business in a dark basement, but not in a sexy way. It would be weird for you to be here and me and Plyer wanting to watch you shag each other in a basement. Charlene, I imagine a lie detector is a sort of approved technique in your field, is it?
No. No, not at all. So, as a therapist, we ask questions, we wait for the answers, and, of course, we also look at body language as well, and that's really quite powerful.
I saw Pasha, you sort of... when she said body language, then you squared off.
Well, it's a professional thing. Is it?
So would you be thrown, Charlene, if I lied, but I was giving you a bit of a titty wag? I've never been unfaithful. Titty waggle.
Titty waggle.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, if you want to do a titty waggle, then of course do that.
I want to. I think people want me to. I don't do it for me. Do it for the morale of the country.
I know, but they do wobble now, don't they?
So shall we delve into some of the things we learned about you as couples during the lie detector test?
Do you mind that she pisses in the shower? Or...
Not at all.
Aww.
It's fun.
Quick, do a rhyme.
she wees on you, does she?
I think you're taking to the next level of fun. No.
The shower's a good place to do that if you are going to
Is it? Some people like that sort of
thing.
They
do.
Some personal experience, right?
Yeah, they call it the golden shower. Just
golden shower.
I just wonder, how do you find out that your other half is into that?
Just sort of drop it in as you're walking down the street. So dog having a piss, you go, lock the old lamppost. No, me neither. Yeah, he is. What do you want to lead with over here? Is it what's on Richard's laptop or the age gap? That
I think you've got over the West.
There's a good chance I'll die, so, you know, after, you don't know.
I didn't entirely think it through, but I will make the best of it.
OK.
Charlene, what did you make of that?
I mean, I am interested what's on Richard's laptop.
Are you?
Well, in the interest of impartiality as well, perhaps now you share together. I'll count to three and you both say offensive video on your laptop here. Right then. Well, I can reveal at the end of that there are numbers and scores involved, and if we take a purely mathematical view, because I'm not qualified to do anything else, Rachel and Pasha, you answered the most questions truthfully, so that round goes to you.
That was our only hope. That was the only one we're going to win.
Right. Time for a little game now called You've Really Done a Number on Me There, You Bastards.
The answer will always be a number. So, for example, we might ask something like, what is the average number of times a couple has sex per week? And you would have to agree on how many. Obviously, zero.
0 point something, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it might not be the same person, mightn't it? So these questions are all based around national averages, and the couple closest to the correct answer gets a point. OK, Charlene, why are we doing this?
Good question. Becoming more general.
Good question. So often we compare ourselves to other people and we think that everyone else is doing something and we're not doing it as often. But when we look at stats, we realise that actually we're probably more in alignment with the average more than we realise.
Yeah. Hopefully. Let's have question number one. How many years into marriage does the average divorce happen?
How long have we been married?
10 years.
I've got an answer ready. From Richard and Catie, like Rachel
five.
And Pasha.
Five.
Yeah. Number person, isn't
it? I would go with one, but OK, let's split the difference.
No, I think that,
two and a half.
I think one will be the mode.
Yeah.
But we want the mean, I think.
Did you guys discuss mode, median, and mean? Right, show your answers.
Oh.
It's five from Rachel.
We went for
and
four
Pasha.
To begin with, which I think four or five might be the answer.
Would you like to reveal? The correct answer is
11 and a half Ooh. Years.
Oh, that's fantastic.
That's almost exactly how long we've been married.
we were closer. Is that the first point we've got?
It is a
yeah,
point,
it
yeah.
is your first point.
Well done.
Yeah. Ooh, what percentage of men send their partner naked pictures?
Of themselves?
Of themselves, yeah, I think so.
So all men? Do you ask some 90-year-old men about this?
From Nigel Farage to Ollie Mears. So, hold up your paddles.
You ready?
Yeah.
Oh! Wow.
52%. Wow, that's very...
We went for Brexit. We thought it'd be the same number of voted for Brexit.
Everyone who voted for Brexit sent stick pics. We've both gone high. It's 27%.
Yeah, I said 30%.
I know.
No. And you're right to make that point. I would as well.
I would have won that!
That's a point to Rachel and Pasha. Still think 27 is high. That was a one in four men. Charlene, do you think? Do you deal with more dick pics?
Yeah, I think, you know, some guys think that that's a way to make a partner feel really excited and kind of get them in the mood. But we know that in particular women will say actually it doesn't really do much for them.
Yeah, cos they're ugly.
Question number three.
What percentage of people in Britain would be prepared to have sex with a robot?
What are you looking at me for?
I like the word prepared. Go on, then.
Is it cheating to have sex with a robot? Because ladies have a bit of a sex robot that they use.
What?
Yeah. A vibrator. Just like, I don't want the rest of the robot, I'll just take the... I'll just take the rest of the
robot. It's only like drawing a face on your hand. OK, it's not like that.
That's the Lancashire sex robot, is it?
Yeah. Draw a little two eyes on your palm.
Hello. Is that what you did?
Are you hungry?
No.
What percentage? Lift your paddles.
23%. Oh, like 50% are straight out, because no woman wants to have sex with a robot, right?
Right.
So you think two in five men want to have sex with a robot?
Prepared to be shocked by the truth, which is 40%. Six out of 10 people wouldn't have sex with a robot. Yeah. You know, you can word it whichever way you like. You can spin it round anyway. We probably shouldn't. The point goes to Richard and Catie.
And the next question is, how many times does the average couple have sex?
Per week.
Per week.
Not ever.
Just with each other as well. Not in a car park.
Real post-kids.
Yeah, 50. Up and down the country now, couples. Not bloody enough. Right, we've got answers. Richard and Kate have gone for...
Ooh!
2.43 times a week.
That's just what we do.
Two.
But some people, you know, it's the average, isn't it? Some people, you know, at the beginning of a relationship, perhaps.
Yeah, yeah. That's it. What is the truth?
What?
How many times do people have sex a week?
I don't know.
I thought you were hosting this, didn't you?
Because I was looking. The correct answer is three times a week.
Three times a week. That's another point for Richard and Peter.
So that round goes to Richard and Catie.
Yeah.
Right, it's time to head back to the retreat, and we genuinely did want to give the couple something more relaxing for their next task. Unfortunately for them, someone had done something unspeakable in the bathroom.
Yeah. Did Rachel Riley piss everywhere?
No, we made a terrible mess in the bathroom, and we asked our couples to work as a team to clean it up. Why have we done this, Charlene?
Well, oftentimes people argue over things like housework. So we wanted to see how the couples work together. Do they make a mess, or do they argue, or do they have lots of fun?
Let's find out.
We look like we're going to close down a takeaway.
This is a real kink of mine, you know, the way you're dressed.
Oh, God, you are a psychopath.
You do this in real life.
What?
You squeeze the toothpaste with...
Like a bear. You said I squeeze it like a bear.
It's like it's been in a clamp.
Hello?
Welcome to hell.
Oh, my. Oh.
That's the tools of your trade.
Right. So it's not me cleaning, it's both of us.
Well, I mean, like she does any cleaning in the house at all.
Really, do you not?
No, I do. I do loads of cleaning.
And what do you do?
I do the kitchen.
Right.
And the hoovering.
Oh, do you?
Yeah. I do.
If someone's coming round, you'll do the hoovering.
Well, that's, of course. Well, there's no point in doing it if it's just us.
Well, you have 15 minutes when I say now.
Well, we can't get it. Why has this bath got a picture in it? What the hell is going on with this?
How do you share out domestic duties?
We don't make such mess, so we don't have to worry about it.
You never shit in your sink? Oh, that's disgusting.
Oh, you went for it. I mean, we might get John.
Whoa, Leslie! She's gone rogue.
Let's not do that.
I mean, if we were to just start a fire and get the sprinklers to come on, we could save all this time.
Can we just chuck that over there?
You've taken a sort of fly-tipping approach.
You've flooded the shower. Slightly blocked. No, don't go back in. It's gone a bit crystal maze, this.
Oh, my God.
Gone a bit crystal meth. Did we book this on your Airbnb or mine? Because I can't handle the bad review.
This is lovely.
Yeah, the tap detail was missing earlier.
Pasha, you're still on the one bloody tap?
Yes, it's going to be the best tap you've ever seen.
3 minutes!
No way!
I cleaned the sink and then I've messed it up again.
If we put everything in the toilet, just close the lid.
I don't think you will need to do this as a living, Pasha, but you know, you could. There's many a lonely woman who would have you around.
Oh, I didn't finish.
finish the toothbrushes. Two.
Oh,
one.
That's lovely. Richard and Catie are going to be gutted when they see that finish.
Yeah.
Please vacate the crime scene.
It's not bad, is it?
The toilet is good, but classic man, he's cleaned it, but he still hasn't put the lid down. You know. From here onwards, there's a clear winner. I guess the debate is, how much of a problem is that? Sort of like my body, isn't it? Most of it is absolutely beautiful, but the bits that are wrong are absolutely disgusting.
I tell you what, Pasha's tap is very shiny.
Oh.
It is.
Yeah, but you've said it with a sort of sexual energy, haven't you?
No, I've never seen his cock.
Just go now, I need the toilet. You can set off as well. It's probably easiest to shit in the shower at this point, isn't it?
Before we get Charlene's take on that, it's time for a quick break. If you're going to pop for a wee and the bathroom's a bit messy, why not spray the walls with a shower head and then shove everything in the bog? See you in a few minutes.
Did you know that 2 million Britons say they've watched a TV show or movie that affected them so much they considered breaking up with their partner? Well, welcome to that show. When we last saw Richard and Catie and Rachel and Pasha, they were cleaning up an extremely dirty bathroom. I do want to come to you and have an in-depth discussion about your use of the dressing gown as a cleaning implement.
Yeah.
But first we'll go to Charlene. Is there anything you saw there that you want to talk about?
Well, there was something that Rachel said that really stayed in my mind.
What was it?
Pasha, you're still on the one bloody tap.
Look, this is going to be the best tap you've ever seen.
Rachel, was there, like, another way that you maybe could have shown your panic?
Yeah, I mean, there was. You were really impressed with his tap, weren't you?
He has a lovely, shiny tap. Was, I mean, as a qualified cleaner, maybe I should judge this one. I have got an MVQ in cleaning. I think I'm going to have to award Rachel and Pasha as the winners.
Wow. I mean, they hid all their stuff in the bath. I mean, I agree. That what was the logic of... Was it just, I'm wearing a towel?
I've found dressing gowns are very absorbent in many situations. We were working with the tiny little cloths, and I thought, I'm just dressed as a cloth.
Do you regret marrying him?
A little bit. She does a little bit. That's the beauty of marriage, isn't it? It's hard to get out of.
When children are involved. Yeah. Anyway.
I tell you what, you don't see many panel shows where you'll go to a link with the phrase, I mean, especially when kids are involved. Rachel and Pasha, you are currently in the lead as well in the show overall. I mean, I don't want to sort of...
Yeah.
But you don't want to lose on telly to a couple who don't share the same native language. It doesn't make the communication in your marriage look great. Right, we asked you each to bring in an item which represents a sort of bone of contention in your relationships. Richard and Catie, what have you brought for us to have a look at?
I've got a... it's this. It's a thing to smooth your... It's not what you're thinking. Do not use that as a vibrator, because this top bit is quite harsh, it's abrasive.
It's a foot buffer.
Foot buffer.
A foot buffer.
Why is it screaming?
It does sound a bit like me.
I've got quite unpleasant feet. Got quite a lot of hard skin on my feet, but I quite like dealing with that myself.
Ooh.
Picking it off when we're watching television. Oh.
I also suffer from foot dry skin.
Yeah.
And it's
amazing television.
Okay, some people at home watching this picking the skin off their feet. And that's, this is for them.
I know it's time when I go to the toilet in the middle of the night and the sound of my feet on the tiles is like an old dog. Its claws are like.
In any case, the bone of contention isn't that I have bad feet. That's irrelevant.
Right.
It's that my wife thinks that's a suitable present. 3 times. Like, has she not got the message? I've not used them. Don't think, oh, I know it needs another one. That's not...
So while we're here and we're discussing communication and honesty, yeah. Catie, when you bought the third fuck off there, did you know you'd already bought the other two?
Do you know what? I did temporarily forget.
Was it just...
Yeah, there's a moisturiser that yours hasn't tried.
Rachel and Pasha, what have you brought in?
Pasha, obviously, he works really hard. Sometimes he's on tour. He gets very tired. And he always falls asleep in random places. And if he falls asleep somewhere weird, I've taken it upon myself to take photos. not, your testicles aren't out in any of them. But I'd like to kind of decorate him a little bit.
You live in yes.
Yeah, that was my necklace. I just did a few shapes. That was my favourite.
If you've got a friend who likes teddy bears,
you can have him a teddy bear. And apparently he doesn't like it. I don't know why.
I mean, I don't mind it. It's when it goes on national television.
I mean, you haven't seen the worst one yet, so I'm slightly worried about the fact that you're annoyed about that one.
We went on this little cruise once, and there's a teeny tiny like cruise ship. He fell asleep stark naked with his bum at the corner of the bed and his legs up against the wall, like completely passed out. I just don't know how you do it.
I think I have my flip-flops on.
There's one by the looks of it.
Who falls asleep like that?
It's very threatening for another man to see that that's the size cushion you reached for. I could do
not
it.
For me, John, oh. Not for me.
Charlene, what would you say in terms of this as a breach of trust in a relationship?
So, you know, the partners are finding creative ways to communicate to their partners that they maybe don't like something. So that's really quite something quite positive.
You'd have to be a real piece of work, though, to photograph a sleeping partner, wouldn't you? You'd have to be a real piece of shit.
John, that's your people, that! Why am I on a... Am I in a house? You bastard.
Sorry, mate. We all right?
Well, that was I was asleep and then I saw you and that was like a death stare, I guess. Let's check back in on our couples retreat. We felt the couples could do with a bit of pampering, so we arranged for a makeover.
Yes, unfortunately for Catie and Rachel, we asked their husbands to apply the makeup. Charlene, what are we doing here apart from setting them up to fail massively?
Well, it's about being able to let go, you know. Do the ladies allow their partners to put the makeup on them? Do they get involved? Or can they really just trust their partners?
It's an experiment in trust. So before we see Richard and Pasha's efforts, I thought I'd have a go on Lucy's face first. OK. Do you trust me?
No. Whoa, what's going on?
I want you in rollers.
That's how you do it.
How are you feeling?
Fine.
How's that sexy husband of yours? He's a real piece of ass. Me and the girls were chatting earlier.
You got that off the streets?
Yeah.
Of Lancaster.
All right, then. Is this foundation, yeah?
That's foundation, yep.
Yeah? Oh, that's nice and orange. You're always saying you're not orange enough. You're very tense, aren't you? What's up, Chuck? Your little goatee beard there. Oh, I'm having fun. Now, I'm going to introduce a little bit of colour now. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Purple? Oh, yes. Oh, I'm really happy with that. What's this?
Liquid eyeliner.
Are you familiar with the reference, the Rum Tom Tugger?
Oh, from Cats?
Yes.
What are you doing on my nose? Don't be so fucking stupid. Get it off. I don't need that on my nose, do I?
I've started a movement here. Contouring's dead. You ready? Presenting Miss Kitty Cat 2022.
Piece of shit. Piece of shit.
It's lovely, isn't it?
You're an absolute piece of shit. It didn't. That thing on my nose didn't come off for 3 days.
Turns out it was a Sharpie. Charlene, to use your expert opinion, am I a piece of shit?
No.
We can edit the gap out. Now, before we see how our couples got on, it's time for another quick break.
If you're watching this with your other half at home, why not use this opportunity to ask them once and for all how many sexual partners they've really had? See you soon. So John and Lucy's Odd Couples, the show that thrives on romance, flirtation, intimacy and passion with your soulmate. Just wish I could find mine.
Perhaps he's watching tonight.
Well, got my number at the bottom.
Before the break, you saw me doing Lucy's makeup, rather tastefully, I thought, during a couples retreat with our guests. So now Richard and Pasha have seen how a pro does it. It's time to see how you chaps got on. Welcome both.
Thank you.
The theme is out on the town.
Would you say that one person looks much happier than another person about what's about to happen? You can, of course, guide Rachel. You can tell him what to do, or you can trust his natural instincts.
Oh, listen, you're going to look amazing.
I mean, I've seen him polish a tap, so, you know.
And that's not a euphemism.
Has Richard ever done your makeup before?
My children have. They drew a third eye on my forehead.
It's amazing with such a low bar that you're still so nervous about Richard doing it. 10 minutes.
OK.
Crack on.
I'm going to go with a smoky eye look.
Well, it's foundation. That's the first thing.
Ooh,
you went straight for that and you knew what it was.
So, first foundation, of course. Yep.
Mm-hmm. There's brushes.
No, we don't need brushes. We don't need brushes where we're going.
It's not sun cream. It's not sun cream. Yeah.
Make you glow even more and prepare you for what's coming next.
That sounds so much more different in your voice than mine. Brace yourself. You're not going to like the next bit. You look like you're made of clay. This has gone so badly so quickly.
That's the foundation.
That is the foundation. You're now ready to build the kitchen on.
A little bit of contour here.
Contouring, great.
Don't cry.
Take some of it off her teeth, maybe.
You've got a tissue. I've got a sock. I've got a sock in my pocket.
So why my face is
a sock? You're going to use a dirty sock. What is that, Richard, you've got there?
I don't know. It's got...
It's like watching a monkey do it.
Look at this.
Oh, I'm seeing it.
And like against the orange.
The good news is, to get this off, we've got a shower that's got barely any shit left on it.
That clashes a bit with the lipstick. That was the first mistake I've made. You've got blue, pink.
What goes well with tears? Like 1 minute for some finishing touches.
Doesn't feel too bad. You might be better than me.
Yeah, it's good.
10 seconds to apply the second eyelash. Just somewhere near the eye would be an improvement on the last one. It's time for the spin and reveal.
Depend on this.
Oh! I mean, to be fair, I've had worse.
I feel like before we let you see what's happened, we should reveal that the next round you get to give Richard a facial tattoo.
So, I think you just need to prepare yourself as well, because it's quite shocking. So just give yourself a moment.
Oh my God. I mean, it does look like a walk of shame kind of look.
Yeah.
I mean, would you take me out like this?
It's very odd. Catie was also asking to be taken out after this, but she was signalling a sniper. I mean, it's difficult to call, isn't it? A little quandary, that one.
It was when you were pumping it out. Like, you were going to lather her whole body in sympathy. And then it was like, did you see the state of your dressing gown? Body everywhere.
It was the most fun I have ever had in my life.
How would you have reacted had Pasha just gone at it?
He could have gone to town, he could have had some fun.
You think that's because you're a dancer as well? You're maybe more in touch with... women.
I had my share of experiences, but I think it's just she's so beautiful. I wouldn't think of damaging this canvas.
Why don't you say that to me?
Because you do that.
Don't do that. Why are you nice? Piece of shit. That's lovely. lovely, isn't it, Charlene? Is that nice?
So lovely. I mean, a man that knows about smoky eye is a man who's very observant and knows exactly what his woman wants. So that's so beautiful to see. And, you know, Catie, you really let go and you really trusted him and, you know, good on you for that.
And I betrayed that trust.
I think, if anything, I kind of blacked out. I remember Lucy saying, it's not sun cream, it's not sun cream. And then the next thing I knew, it was over.
Well, I'd love to say it's remotely unclear, but the points there go to Rachel and Pasha. We've played all our rounds now, and I can reveal, Rachel and Pasha, you are ahead, but it's still all to play for because the fire alarm could go off. Still a lot for you to do there in our final round. Two of you are about to be hooked up to our in-studio lie detector, which we nicked from the posh house we were filming at earlier. We're going to ask you a series of very, very difficult questions to see if through the show you've learned to be more honest with one another. For every question you answer truthfully, you will receive a point added to your total. Here's some extra motivation. Win tonight, and not only will you go home with the title of best couple, there's an actual prize too.
Rachel and Pasha, because Rachel keeps doing her, you know, a business in the shower, you'll be playing for a professional deep clean of your entire house.
I really want that. It's been... I don't think we've had it since we moved into that house.
A deep clean.
Yep.
Richard and Catie, to help soothe Richard's hideous feet, you have the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to win a luxury foot spa.
Ooh. Gold
point. I mean, I don't know if you've understood. I don't want any more foot base.
Richard and Rachel, let's play Home Truths. How are you both feeling?
Worried I'm going to fart.
I'm also worried he's going to fart.
Then let's play.
Right. Rachel, do you think you and Pasha have better chemistry than Richard and Catie?
Yes.
No, that's the truth.
Damn you, machines!
Richard.
Yep.
If something bad happened to you, would you want Catie to find love again?
No.
It's the truth.
I think she should be buried with me in a pyramid, Pharaoh style. Just to keep her on the straight and narrow.
Rachel, we know you piss in the shower. Have you ever weed anywhere else than the toilet?
No.
You just piss everywhere.
There was one time when I had a few too many drinks at uni and decided to get on a bike. But it was raining, so no one would have known if you hadn't have asked me today. Damn you kids.
Right, so your next question. Is there currently pornography on your computer?
No, I don't keep it on the computer. It's beautiful footage of people making love with each other.
Right then.
Rachel, do you think you would have done better on Strictly if Pasha was a better dancer?
I don't think you can be a better dancer than Pasha.
No, there is one who's a bit better though, isn't there?
I think he could have been a better teacher, but he's a good dancer.
Oh, I felt that. Did you not see my titty waggle earlier? Richard, earlier you implied, in fairness, Lucy implied, that you were well endowed. Would you be happy to take 3 inches off your penis for 3 inches to be added to your height?
I'm not prepared to go under 10 inches. The thing is, if you're little, it looks bigger. That's it. So, no.
You say no, is that true or a lie? What a lovely end.
No, sorry, I just burped then. Say that again.
Oh, no, I think we'll keep that in. I think it's important. I think it's important that people know the truth. So at the end of that round, I can reveal that, Richard, you told the most truths in that round, but the victory is still Rachel and Pasha.
I've just realised who you look like. Oh. You look like one of those people that comes to check for the Guinness World Record.
Most robots fucked in an hour. Tonight's best couple are Rachel and Pasha. Congratulations. Well, Charlene, I feel like you've seen a lot tonight. What would you say your main takeaway from tonight's show is going to be?
Well, there's a lot that comes to mind, of course, and this is one of the first things. Yes. Yeah.
Which goes to show that maybe Britain is tired of experts. Charlene Douglas, everyone.
But Rich and Pasha, you don't just leave as our best couple. You get to take home an actual prize too. Yes, tonight you are going to leave with a deep clean of your house.
That's the best thing anyone's ever said to me.
Richard and Catie, commiserations. You are tonight's runners-up, and your prize is this. It's a voucher for a one-hour session with Charlene. Sadly, it's not therapy, it's a spin class.
Is that it, then?
I think so. The laughter stopped. So... Thanks very much and good night. Let's all head off to our dressing rooms.
Oh, no, not again!
Sorry.
Just, there's no time now, just shove it all in.
Don't let go.
I can stay here forever!
That's a lie!